Hello students, today in the chapter number 7 coordinate geometry we will solve exercise 7.2 problems based on section formula. So let's start. So question number 5 says find the ratio in which the line segment joining A 1 minus 5 and B minus 4 5 is divided by the x-axis, and also find the coordinates of the point of division. Now here this line segment AB divided by a point, but that point lie on the x-axis. Now when the point lie on the x-axis, its x-coordinate is there, but why the y-coordinate is 0. So let us take the point P divides the joining of line segment AB in the ratio m1 is to m2, and coordinate of this point P is x0. So here the two points are, and the line AB is divided by the point P in the ratio m1 into m2. So we can use the section formula for the coordinate of point PXY, m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. This is for x coordinate and this is for y coordinate. Now here A, this is the first point, so 1 and minus 5 is x1 y1. And B is the second point, so minus 4 and 5 are the x2 and y2. Now put the values here. So coordinate of point P is given by m1 into minus 4 plus m2 into 1 upon m1 plus m2. And for y, m1 into 5 plus m2 into minus 5 upon m1 plus m2. Here in this equation, we are putting the values of x1, y1, x2 and y2. So by solving this, minus 4 m1 plus m2 upon m1 plus m2 is equal to 5 m1 minus 5 m2 upon m1 plus m2. Now here the coordinate of this point P is given x0. Now here we will equate with the coordinates x with the coordinate x, and the coordinate y is equating with the coordinate y. So we get x coordinates is x is equals to minus 4 m1 plus m2 upon m1 plus m2, and for y coordinate we have 0 is equal to 5 m1 minus 5 m2 upon m1 plus m2. Now separately we will find it out for x and y value for these coordinates. So first of all we will take this 0 is equal to 5 m1 minus 5 m2 upon m1 plus m2. Now here when we cross multiply it, or we transpose this denominator into the left hand side, it will become 0 into m1 plus m2. So we get 0 is equals to 5 m1 minus 5 m2. Now this minus 5 m2 goes to the left hand side, it will become 5 m2. So 5 m1 is equal to 5 m2. From both sides, 5 will be cancelled out. We get m1 is equal to m2. Now here the meaning of the m1 is equals to m2 is both the sections of this line divided by the point P are same. So we can say line divided in the ratio 1 is to 1. Then after, by putting the value for x, we get the value for x also. Now in this equation, x is equals to minus 4 m1 plus m2 upon m1 plus m2. We put the value of m1 is equal to m2, or we can replace this m2 by m1. So I am writing here m2 is equal to m1. So minus 4 m1 plus m1 upon m1 plus m2. By this we get minus 3 m1 upon 2 m1. Now these 3 m1 and 2 m1, this m1 quantity will cancel out. We get x is equals to minus 3 by 2. So we can say here the coordinate of the point P is minus 3 by 2, 0. And this point P divides the line AB in the ratio 1 is to 1. Now one important thing we have to remember here, this point lies on the x-axis, correct? So there is x-coordinate has the value, but the y-coordinate is 0. Now remember, when the point lie on the y-axis, so x-coordinate is 0 and y-coordinate has the value. Now let's take the next problem. Question number 7, find the coordinates of a point A where AB is the diameter of a circle whose center is 2 minus 3 and B 1, 4. So let's take center of the circle is O whose coordinate is given 2 minus 3 and the diameter is given AB and we have to find out the coordinate of A. Point A is given by XY and for point B is given 1, 4. Now here remember, we have given the diameter and we know that the diameter is the longest chord which is equal to twice of radius. So here we can say OA is equal to OB is equal to radii. So in this case, the center of the circle divides the diameter in the same section. So we can say here, in the same ratio. So the ratios are M1 and M2. So M1 ratio M2 is 1:1. Now we can apply the section formula here. By this, using M1:M2 is 1:1. But when we put the values M1 and M2 here, 1, we get X2 plus X1 upon 2 and Y2 plus Y1 upon 2. So this is the formula for coordinates of the midpoint. So we can use whenever we have to find the coordinates of the midpoint. So x1 plus x2 upon 2 and y1 plus y2 upon 2. So by putting the value of x2, x1, y1, y2 in this problem, as the coordinate of the center is given 2 minus 3. So 2 minus 3, that is equals to 1. x2 value is 1 plus x, so 1 plus x upon 1 plus 1, and y1 plus y2 is y plus 4, so upon 1 plus 1. Now here 2 minus 3 is equal to 1 plus x upon 2 and 4 plus y upon 2. So by equating the coordinates according to xx and yy, we get, when we equate the coordinate of x, 2 is equal to 1 plus x upon 2. And when we equate the coordinates of y, minus 3 is equal to 4 plus y upon 2, these two. Now, solve this. 2 into 2, when we transpose this 2, it is equal to 4. So, 1 plus x is equal to 4 and this 1 will transpose to the left hand side. We get 3 is equal to x. Similarly, when we solve this one, minus 3 is equal to 4 plus y upon 2. This 2 will transpose to this left hand side, becomes minus 6 is equal to 4 plus y. And this minus 4 will transpose to the left hand side again. We get minus 6 minus 4 is equal to minus 10. So here we are having the value x is 3 and value y is minus 10. So we can say the coordinate of this end point of the diameter is 3 minus 10. So remember one formula also here, by using the section formula, and by section formula we have one more formula for midpoints of the line segment given by x1 plus x2 upon 2, y1 plus y2 upon 2. Now let's take one more problem, the question number 8, which says if A and B are minus 2 minus 2 and 2 minus 4 respectively. These are the coordinates of point A and point B. Find the coordinates of P such that AP is equal to 3/7 of AB and P lies on the line segment AB. Now take here A and B are the points and P is dividing this line segment and coordinates of P is given by XY. Now here we have to given AP is equal to 3/7 of AB. Now, this AB will transpose to the left hand side. So, we get AP upon AB is equal to 3/7. Now, by the figure, we observe that AB, we can write it as AP plus PB. So, AB is AP plus BB. Now, put in this, we get AP upon AP plus BP. Place the value of AB as AP plus BP, we get this equation AP upon AP plus BP is equal to 3/7. Now take the reciprocal of this in both the sides. So we get AP plus BP upon AP is equal to 7/3. Remember here, we are taking the reciprocals in both the sides. So we get this equation. Now AP upon AP plus BP upon AP, we can do this. Yes, AP upon AP plus BP upon AP is equals to 7/3. Now this AP upon AP will cancel out, so we get 1 plus BP upon AP is equal to, now this 7 we can write as 3 plus 4 upon 3. Now this again we can have 3/3 plus 4/3. So 3/3 becomes 1. So in both the sides, when we compare, 1 plus BP upon AP is equal to 1 plus 4 upon 3. So 1 and 1 both are equal. That meaning this BP upon AP is equal to 4 upon 3. So we have BP upon AP is 4 upon 3. So we can say now that a ratio of AP and BP is 3:4. Now here, this ratio is 3:4. First of all, in this problem, we have find out the ratio, that it is given in the form of AP is 3/7 of AB. So actual ratio, we have this line segment divided by the point P in the ratio 3:4. Now we can use the section formula. AP and BP ratio is given 3:4. So that is point P divides AB in the ratio 3:4. And now applying the section formula, that is coordinates of this point PXY given by M1 X2 plus M2 X1 upon M1 plus M2. And for Y, M1 Y2 plus M2 Y1 upon M1 plus M2. Put the values here as A, that is X1 Y1, and B, that is X2 Y2. So we place the values. X1 is -2, Y1 is -2, X2 is 2, and Y2 is -4. So put the values. M1, that is 3, X2 is 2 plus 4 into X1 is -2 upon 3 plus 4, and then 3, Y2 is -4 plus 4, M2 is 4, and Y1 is -2 upon 3 plus 4. Then after solving this, 3 2 is 6, minus 4 2 is 8 upon 3 plus 4 7. And for Y, 4 3 is -12 and 4 2 is -8 upon 7. After subtracting this, we get value for PXY is -2 upon 7 and Y -20 upon 7. So in this way, we have the coordinates of this point P is -2 upon 7 and -20 upon 7, which divides the line segment AB in the ratio 3:4. Now remember, whenever the ratio is given like this problem, AP is equals to 3/7 of AB. So we have to take the AB in the left hand side. So we will get the AP upon AB is equals to 3/7, and we will solve it out, then get the actual ratio is 3:4. Then by applying the section formula, we will have the coordinates of the point P which divides the line segment AB in the given ratio. So I hope you will understand the problems and try to solve the problems based on the section formula.